That's so insightful because I feel also it's a question and a statement simultaneously because we, especially in India right now, feel like we're on the brink of like different people's movements that are not completely united but still are like locked in because from the CAA protests earlier this year to like what's happening in Molem in Goa right now. So do you think that there is a people's revolution that's like slowly underway here that can have a larger voice than the like the overarching government who does not want to listen to the to what truth, power, and our problems are? Like, how do we relate and how do we answer these like the peaceful protest culture? How do we maintain and continue that like strong in its strength that is there right now?
That's there. It's, I think it's for one, let's not assume that this started overnight.
No.
We've had powerful protest movements for ages, for as long as India has been independent. My own starting and entry point was in 2010, 11, and looking at that time, there was a Niyamgiri movement, there was a POSCO movement. It's just a lot of urban movements that seem to be visible. Right, like urban literate movements that seem to also be sprouting up. So that's what we see. Whereas in terms of rural, in terms of Adivasi, Dalit movements, these have always existed. So I think first thing to do is to acknowledge that they have been leading the charge for a long time. How can we extend solidarity, learn, and how to carry out long-term resistance movements? The Niyamgiri struggle was for 10 years, POSCO movement 12 years. I would always be told once you start that some of these protest movements or fights for accountability will outlast your relationships. They have. My marriage was lasted shorter than the Niyamgiri movement, or if you were to say that of these movements for corporate accountability. And it takes time, and like it does take relay handholding. And it's not like, okay, we're used to a very Twitter quote of justice of if success isn't achieved in a day, then we cave. We're like, okay, no, we're used to instant gratification, Instagram likes and shares, and immediately if I made a witty post, everybody clap for me, versus putting yourself sometimes not in the limelight, doing the work of organizing people, a lot of that. And CA was amazing. But I think now, I think one of the things is to like understand just how pervasive power has become, and that in we have become, I mean, I know this is going to be like, I feel immobilized, right? Like, I mean, we have become far too fearful for our own good. And this is going to take numbers. So now looking at what's happening in Delhi, in Haryana, in Punjab, that's something that gives me life. And we need to extend our solidarity to that. And sometimes it's not just by Insta likes and shares, but where can we also bring the numbers? And that's what the state is afraid of. One is slander, but like at the same time, we're talking about numbers. And if the poor can do it in such large numbers, well, what is preventing us?
That's certainly.
Yeah.